Hi, everyone. I'm honored to be with you this evening. 3 years ago, I attended my congressman's one and only public event of the year in St. Charles, Illinois. That night, he made a promise to my community. He said he would not vote to repeal health care protections for people with pre-existing conditions, people like me. My name is Lauren Underwood, and I'm a registered nurse and public health expert who worked to implement the Affordable Care Act. So you know I was following this debate really closely. 2 weeks after he made that promise to his constituents, he went back on his word. I knew our community deserved better representation in Congress, so I decided, you know what? It's on. I'm running. With the support of my community, we unseated a four-term Republican member of Congress in a district formerly held by the Republican Speaker of the House. I come before you today as the youngest Black woman to ever serve in the Congress and the first woman and first millennial to ever represent Illinois' beautiful 14th district. I am one member of the youngest Congress in a generation, the most diverse Congress in American history. And let me tell you, women's voices are the loudest, boldest, and most powerful coming out of our Congress. Women are leading the way and are saving our democracy. In Congress, it's women who are fighting for paid family leave and affordable child care, women fighting for health care for our families, women fighting for equal pay, and women are fighting for our public school teachers and students. These priorities have only become more urgent in the face of the coronavirus pandemic because these issues aren't just women's issues. We're talking about our families, our health, and our communities. This pandemic represents a once-in-a-generation crisis that will change our world forever. But it's also a once-in-a-generation opportunity to catapult us into an economy and a healthcare system that works for everyone. And I know that women will lead the way because it's women who are on the front lines of this pandemic. Think about our nurses, our social workers, our grocery store clerks, our frontline workers in this nation are women. We have to remember, even in good times, working women face a staggering pay gap. Compared to every dollar earned by white men, Latina women earn 54 cents on the dollar, Native women earn 57 cents, and Black women earn 62 cents. So because our Republican colleagues in the Senate have refused to come to the negotiating table for another coronavirus relief bill, it's working women and their families who are facing the consequences. And let's be clear, the consequences that we're talking about are life and death. Women need us to step up and fight for their families, their health, and their livelihoods, and they need us now. I'm here today because of the women who came before me. Congresswoman Jeanette Rankin, a woman elected to Congress 4 years before women received the constitutional right to vote, was instrumental in passing the 19th Amendment 100 years ago. I wear white in honor of her work. Congresswoman Shirley Chisholm, a personal hero of mine, showed us all how to lead fearlessly. The first Black Congresswoman in our history, unbought and unbossed. Senator Carol Mosley Braun, the first Black woman ever elected to the Senate. As a child, it was striking to see my senator look like me. Every single day, I see women like Shannon Watts, Agent Pooh, Brittany Packnett, and Lorella Pirelli doing the work, leading us to a more perfect union. And listen, I know we call it Obamacare, but we would not have the Affordable Care Act without our fearless leader, Speaker Nancy Pelosi. My family always taught me that courage was grounded in choosing to act. Courage is choosing to start that business you always dreamed of. It's knowing that just because it hasn't been done before doesn't mean that you can't do it. For me, courage was stepping into my congressional race as a 30-year-old Black woman with a full-time job, with the certainty that my community deserved better representation in Congress and the belief that I could offer it. During that campaign, I heard from families in my community who desperately needed help. I heard from people who had to ration insulin and other prescription drugs due to high cost. So I wrote the Lower Insulin Costs Now Act, which was signed into law by the president to make certain that no parent has to worry about how they would pay for their child's insulin. And it's not just that prescription drugs are too expensive, it's that premiums and doctor's visits and co-payments are too expensive. There are families in the 14th district who are spending 25% of their income on healthcare premiums. So I wrote the Healthcare Affordability Act, and I know our future president, Joe Biden, will help me push that legislation across the finish line. I also decided to take on a project that's deeply personal to me. In Illinois, women who look like me are 6 times more likely to die from a pregnancy-related complication than white women. 72% of those deaths are preventable. The United States, it has the highest maternal mortality rate in the developed world, and it's only getting worse. As a registered nurse, I knew I could make a difference, so I teamed up with a colleague from North Carolina, Dr. Alma Adams, to co-found the Black Maternal Health Caucus and save moms' lives. In March, Congresswoman Adams and I, along with our future vice president and my friend Senator Kamala Harris, introduced the Black Maternal Health Momnibus Act of 2020, comprehensive legislation to address this health crisis. Look at what can happen when we have real representation in the Congress. And even though we represent more than half of the U.S. population, women only represent less than a quarter of the United States Congress. But I know that we're going to have more women join us come November. Ladies, this is the most important election of our lifetime. So here's the deal. I know that we are always chatting with our girlfriends about the best books to read or shows to stream, but this year, we've got to check in with everyone to make sure that we know what's on the ballot this fall. Our democracy, our healthcare, our reproductive freedom, it's all on the line, and it's on us to send 2 champions to the White House for women and working families. I'm talking about Vice President Joe Biden and Senator Kamala Harris. Girlfriends, it's time. Men, it's time. I'm calling on you to make a plan to vote and join us in the work to restore our democracy. Friends, it's on. Thank you.